also the author of the book Big White Ghetto, Dead Broke, Stone Cold Stupid, and High on Rage in the Dank Woolly Wilds of the, quote, real America. Kevin, I've got good news and bad news for you. The bad news is I don't know how much we're going to be able to get to your book because Mika wants to read your entire column.
It's so good.
Enjoyed it so much. Mika, take a little run at it, and then we'll do your dramatic reading, and then we'll get to the book.
Well, it's called Witless Ape Rides Helicopter. Well, that sucked. Memo to MAGA and its myriad fellow travelers. Maybe Death of a Salesman, as presented by Leni Riefenstahl, just wasn't the show Americans were dying to tune into this season. And while we're at it, maybe turning your party over to Generalissimo Walter Mitty, his hideous scheming spawn, and the studio audience from Hee Haw was just not absolutely aces as a political strategy. Think on it, Cletus. I know this whole thing still sounds like your idea of a good time. How's that working out for you? Let me refresh your memory. On the day Donald Trump was sworn in as president, Republicans controlled not only the White House, but both houses of Congress. They were in a historically strong position elsewhere as well, controlling both legislative chambers in 32 states. They pissed that away like they were midnight drunks karaoke warbling that old Chumbawunga song. In 2021, they control approximately squat. The House is run by Nancy Pelosi. The Senate is run, as a practical matter, by Kamala Harris. And Joe Biden won the presidency, notwithstanding whatever the nun-cutlet guest hosting for Dennis Prager this week has to say about it. Donald Trump is, in fact, the first president since Herbert Hoover to lead his party losing the presidency, the House, and the Senate all in a single term. Along with being the first president to be impeached twice, the first game show host elected to office, that's Trump's claim to the history books. Well, that and 400,000 dead Americans and the failed coup d'etat business. As for the ratings Trump fears and worships, ask the third lady, Melania Trump, departs the scene, the most unpopular presidential wife in recorded statistical history. You Trumpish Republicans sneered that Joe Biden was too corrupt and too senescent to win a presidential campaign, that he was one part mafioso and one part turnip. The turnipped kicked your dumb asses from Delaware to D.C. So you rioted. Real smart move, Cletus. Five Americans are dead. Barricades have been erected around the Capitol. Thousands of federal troops have been deployed to steal the streets of Washington. State capitals have been obliged to prepare for siege. Americans blame you for this, and they are not wrong. Trust the plan, the QAnon cultists say. Is this what you were planning? I know you are stupid, but you're not that stupid. Oh, but he fights, you'll say, over and over and over. He didn't fight, he tweeted. He's 10 feet tall on social media and a pushover in real life. Trade deficit up, unemployment rate rising, abortion rate rising, Beijing rising, the coronavirus body count rising. But he sure did tweet a lot, and he pardoned Roger Stone. At least he took care of that pressing national priority. But the judges, you protest. Fair point. Trump's absurd attempts to overturn the election through the specious legal challenges were laughed out of court by the very men and women he appointed to the bench. Even his judges think he's a joke. Everyone has figured that out except you. And so, goodbye, Donald J. Trump, the man who wanted to be Conrad Hilton, but turned out to be Paris Hilton. Au revoir, Ivanka, Jared, Uday, and Kusey. There's a table for four reserved for you at Dorsia. So long, Melania. It's still not entirely clear what you got out of this, but I hope it was worth it. A fond farewell to Ted Cruz's reputation and Mike Pence's self-respect, Lindsey Graham's manhood, and Fox News's business model. In with Dr. Jill Biden, out with Dr. Sebastian Gorka. Good night, ladies. Good night, sweet ladies. Good night. Good night. I'm sure we'll all meet again, but I'd really rather we didn't.
So there's a dramatic reading, and Kevin Williamson, you get extra points for referencing not once but twice Cletus the slack-jawed yokel. Oh.